Women deal with divorce very differently. One of those differences can wind up costing women a lot of money. There are two high-profile divorces that show how different things can turn out. Kelsey and Camille Grammer and Courtney Cox and David Arquette. Joining us right now is attorney and clinical psychologist David J. Glass.
Interesting David, combo. Very important combination.
Psychologist first, then law, then divorce. What a combination.
Yeah, it works out all right. People going through divorces are going through some of the hardest times of their lives, and a lot of what they're going through is emotional rather than just legal or technical.
Why does it affect women differently than men in that respect?
Specifically with the houses in these two cases, in general, women try to hold on to the house, the marital residence. They've put more time into it. They've put a lot of effort into building up the house.
It's the homestead.
And they want to hold on to it. And in any divorce, there's a huge sense of loss, and the loss of relationship, of money, some friends, some status. And women tend to want to hold on to what they still have.
And the
house,
emotion.
Right.
But one of your tips is to try to take the emotion out of it. That's so much, it's easier said than done. How do you recommend that people actually do that?
They have to listen to their divorce lawyer. They have to listen to at least one trusted friend, whether that's a family member, a mom, a dad, a sister, someone who from the outside can tell them, is this house really the most important thing here, or is your financial security
but
much important?
But usually if you're in an emotional state at that point, your decision making as to who that friend is may not be right. So that trusted friend can be giving you the exact wrong advice.
Right, and that's, although unfortunately that's not a trusted friend. So it's what your definition of a friend is. You need someone who's going to support you emotionally, but also be able to give you some feedback rationally.
And when kids are involved, I would think the house becomes a much bigger issue. And if you're raising kids there, it's got to be really hard to want to get up and try and sell the house.
And that's the way a lot of people think. And interestingly, the psychology literature doesn't bear that out. I've done all the research, and there's not a single study that shows that whether children stay in the same house or move is important to children at all or their well-being.
But that's intellectual. That's not emotional.
Right.
You can tell that to someone. They may not feel that, though.
Correct. But the emotional thing that children need and that parents need to do is to provide stability and consistency for their children through their relationship, not through things.
Given the theory, of course, we exist in, it only matters if it happens to celebrities. Let's go back to those celebrity examples.
Because they did things completely differently.
They did.
Kelsey Grammer and his
Camille.
Wife. Camille, what happened there?
Now, they fought over a divorce for almost 2 years, from 2008 from 2010 to 2012. Camille Grammer chose to keep their Malibu mansion, which at that point was valued at about $17 million.
Ooh.
And she chose that as an asset, and in choosing that asset, she had to offset that versus other money somewhere else. When you divide things, it has to come out relatively equal on both sides. So she chose to keep the house. Now, a year later, she's looking to sell it, and she's already had to drop the price $3 million as of the beginning of last week.
Well, that was like a pre-recession number before, and then everything changed.
Well, I mean, they bought it in 1998 for $4.5 million, so no one's crying over the deal.
Is it because the state of real estate right now, too, that it used to be a safer way to go, but now with everything changing and prices going down, you're saying it's not...
It's very hard to predict, and what her choice was to take the house, and that if it sold for more, she would get the benefit, but if it sells for less, she alone takes the downside.
And then if you keep the house, you have all the expenses in the house, which you have to think about in advance. The other celebrity couple who did it right.
Now, David Arquette and Courtney Cox, they did everything amicably through a mediator. They didn't fight, they never went to court. There was never anything in the press about them causing trouble for each other. And what they did is they decided to hold on to the house together until a point where the market went up. If the market went up, they would sell it, and they would both make money. Mm-hmm. If it went down, they would split the loss.
But you said a key word there. It's amicable. It's amicable.
Yeah.
You can work anything out.
They were communicating.
Correct.
Well, they don't want to kill each other.
Right.
And you've been probably in the middle of all of that.
Right. On the amicable ones and the disastrous ones.
Okay. And can you tell first day what it's going to be?
Usually. Mm-hmm. People come into the office. I can tell where they are when I hear about the spouse, and then most importantly, unfortunately, when I hear who the other attorney is.
For more information and want to connect with David, you can go to our website, myfoxla.com, with more of that. And come back. We'll talk a little more about divorce, the emotional issues, et cetera, okay?
Great.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Great, thank you.
You're never going to get divorced, right?
Never.
Good.
You?
No.
Never.
No.
Done.
Not too old.